So we're talking up Norton, and one of the legends for me when we talk about it on the radio is Andy from Norton Fisheries, a man that's big, big fellow in the local community, aren't you?
I am.
How long have you had the fish shop?
I've had it for 6 years now, and I'm really, really proud of the place and the community, and there's a lot of good people coming to the fish shop, and I think if you just put good quality fish and chips out, then people keep coming back.
Well, what do you think a local fish shop brings to an area? Because you know, you get a bit of banter going on, don't you?
It brings a nice banter, you're right there, it brings a bit of banter. They all come in, they're all regulars, you all have a laugh. And they like the staff, and I think the staff make it as well. The staff make the shop.
We had one of those President Obama moments where we had to say something that means a lot to people of Norton. What would you say is the one great thing that's changed here?
Well, there's not a lot of great changes, and that's what makes it so nice about the place. You know, you can see from round about all the places. It's just a quaint, nice old place, and I think it's very fine. I don't think a lot of modern stuff would change the village.
No.
And with it being in a conservation area.
You've had the fish shop, what, 15 years?
Six.
Oh, 6 years, sorry.
It's 84 years old.
Yeah.
84 years old, and round about here, there's a lot of places around Norton where the hundreds of years old, really.
What would anything make you leave Norton, or you just...
No, nothing would make me leave, but, you know, it's a nice fish shop, and the people, the customers are very nice to me, and the staff, and it's a great place to be.
I've never seen anything like this, the duck pond, before. It's beautiful.
Duck pond's, I don't know how long it's been here, but it's only just been renovated recently, and as you can see, you know, from behind me, it's clean regular, and it's maintained regular as well.
And I take it you've had all the fish out of it and battered them, have you?
Oh, have I done that?
Nice to speak to you, mate.
Okay, mate, yeah, thanks.
Thanks for watching this. It's Talk Up the Evening Gazette and TFM Radio here with local businessman David. Just tell us the business that you do.
I have the news agents on the green. It's the only one around here, so, you know, and we cater for sweets, drinks, everything.
You must find out everything. We see what happens in the news agents at Coronation Street.
Yes, we get to know everything that goes on. We're I like to think, the hub of the community.
I would say so. Without a local news agent, I mean, let's just focus on the great stuff you do. Let's focus on what would happen if you wasn't here.
Well, I think, well, first of all, people would have to walk all the way up the high street, and we have a lot of people who are getting on a bit, and it's hard walking for them to go up there. We like to provide a service for them and make sure that we see them on a regular basis as well.
And having a newsagent just to my left, what a great view you've got. How many people have said they've got this view from here?
It's perfect. Perfect view. It's and in the summertime, it's lovely here. It really is.
Just tell me what looks really nice in Norton across the season. So you've got spring, summer, autumn, winter. What would you say are the picturesque bits?
I do like the winter scenes. If we get plenty of snow, this is lovely, especially early in the morning when I'm around at 5 in the morning. You know, nobody's walked on it. It's beautiful here then.
And place to go for anyone coming here thinking, I'm going to pass through Norton, it's going to be a hot day, where should we go?
Come down to the green, get a drink, you can get pies from over there, get your hair done if you want, over the road. You know, Norton's got a lot of things and some nice cafes and restaurants.
They say Britain's got talent, what has Norton got?
It's a certain quaint, it's a village aspect that it has. It's still very much a village, and there's not many around like this, you know. And with the green being preserved, and there's listed buildings around here.
Nice speaking to you. So here with local resident June. I see you bought out the sun, June. Thank you very much for that. What's so fantastic about Norton then? Why should people come here? Why should people develop their business?
It's a picture postcard village.
Yeah.
It's not quite as pictured, it's not quite as village
as
that suggests, but it is lovely.
So what would you say is the best changes here in the last few years?
Well, trees were cut down and replanted.
Oh, nice.
It's amazing, you know, how short a time they've taken to grow.
And the people are lovely, aren't they?
They are, yes.
Everyone's got a lovely smile, including you.
Thank you.
Very nice to meet you, June. Thank you very much. This is Talk Up with the Evening Gazette and TFM Radio, where we get to meet lovely local people. Eileen, how long have you been a resident in Norton?
I've lived here 40 years.
Well, that's a long time, isn't it?
A long time, yes.
Britain's Got Talent, what has Norton got? So is there any success stories that have come from the heart of Norton? Whether it be singing, political, anything that you think?
Yes, there has been a Scot who lives in Esquim. He was a runner-up
Oh, is he the guy with the autism?
He's got autism, yeah.
What did he do for Norton then? How did he put it on the map? Just tell me the vibe that went on when he was obviously on the national stage.
Well, everybody was so excited because it's unusual for anybody from Norton, as you know. It's just look at the draw and he's got autism. He's brought it out.
What would you say, if you had to go down and to meet these people that do the capital culture and all that sort of stuff, what would you say to them is the best development here in Norton? I know it's great being left as it is. Is there any new building that you thought, you know what, that's pretty damn good?
In Norton?
New developments, yeah.
New development. No, I think it's fine as it is, really.
So you just think it's just perfectly quaint,
it's
perfectly
quaint. It's a lovely, lovely area.
Now, we know the youth today aren't all muggers wearing hoodies. I mean, that's just a bad representation. But do you feel safe at night around here?
I do in this area. There's certain other areas I wouldn't go on a night, but this area, yes.
It's fantastic. Do you know what it is? I look at this and I think, yarm without the snobbery a little bit, really. It's very
easy going. It is. It's just lovely.
Yeah, anyone will help you, wouldn't it?
Oh, yes, everybody puts themselves out, everybody helps one another.
Very nice talk to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Cheers.
It's Talk Up in the lovely area of Norton here with Tim, who works at North Tees Hospital. I've heard so much about this place, it's absolutely amazing. The good thing about Talk Up, I've got to see things I perhaps would never normally get out to see. And what are the other hidden beauty spots of Norton?
It's a lovely clean area, there's plenty of good people. It's it's well kept and people have a lot of respect for the areas. There's
any big employers in the area?
Well, obviously the North East Hospital. The building works up the top of Junction Lane, Harcross, I think it is, or Crosley's, whatever they call it now. It's a nice place, isn't
it? It's not that busy traffic-wise, is it? I mean, it seems to me the road structure of this place is really good. There's lots of places to park, it's easy to get around.
There is plenty of parking, there's loads of facilities for your shopping, and I'm looking at Blackwell's, the Butcher's there, which is a very popular place.
Yeah, it has got everything.